Thanks everyone for being here. It's my great honor and pleasure to be here and to help kick off CESC. And given my academic roots, it's great to see that in the blockchain domain, we have so many wonderful, you know, everyone here to really support research and education in blockchain. So thanks everyone for being here. So my name is Dong Song. I'm a professor at UC Berkeley and founder and CEO at Oasis Labs. So today I will talk about what we do at Oasis towards building a privacy-first cloud computing platform on blockchain. As we all know, data is the new oil. And this data help us to extract valuable information and make better decisions. However, a lot of this data is also very sensitive. And handling sensitive data can pose a lot of challenges. For example, we continue to see really large-scale data breaches where attackers compromise and attack companies and they steal hundreds of millions of users' information in one go. And also, most of this data is siloed. For example, it's difficult for medical researchers to gain access to data to do medical research due to the security and privacy concerns. And so a lot of valuable data is actually now being utilized. And at the same time, users are losing control of their data, as evidenced in the recent Cambridge Analytica incident. And many people actually have been pondering, maybe it's time to have an internet bill of rights. So at Oasis, we are designing and developing new technologies to build what we call privacy-first cloud computing on blockchain with a set of unique capabilities and properties. So first, providing strong security and privacy protection. And second, to provide high performance for complex smart contracts and applications at a cloud scale ranging from games to machine learning and with built-in privacy-preserving data analytics and machine learning. And we hope to support others with decentralized trust without relying on any central party. So first, let me give you a motivating example, what kind of problems this type of technology can help address. So let's look at the application domain of fraud detection. So when banks give out loans and provide financial services, they need to detect fraud. And typically today, each bank utilizes its own data to build its own fraud detection mechanism. And as we all know, for machine learning, the more data and the more diverse data one has, then it can really help build better machine learning models. So wouldn't it be nice if the different banks can actually put the data together to build one fraud detector? However, today it's difficult to do this for a number of reasons. The data is really sensitive, and also there may be misaligned incentives. So using the technology that we developed at the Oasis, we can enable a different approach. Where on the Oasis blockchain platform, we can enable smart contracts for fraud detection. And this fraud detection smart contract can pull data from different banks, and then utilizing all this data to build one fraud detection model. And in this case, the fraud detection model can help improve the accuracy and efficacy for fraud detection for the different banks. Of course, in order to address, to enable this capability, we'll need to address a number of challenging problems. So first, the data can be very sensitive. And hence, as we compute on this sensitive data, on different compute workers, we need to protect the sensitive data from leakage. We need to protect the computation process from leaking sensitive information. And also, at the same time, the computed fraud detection model or the computation outputs may also leak sensitive information, since these computation results is computed from the sensitive input to start with. And hence, we need to protect, provide methods to protect the computation results from leaking sensitive information. And finally, we also need to enable much greater scalability for the blockchain platform, especially to enable such complex smart contracts. At Oasis, we are building privacy-preserving smart contracts at scale. One of the key primitives and capabilities that we provide in the Oasis blockchain platform is what we call privacy-preserving smart contracts. With a set of unique capabilities and properties. First, we enable automatic enforcement of codified privacy requirements, where the privacy requirements are encoded as code inside the smart contract and automatically enforced by the Oasis blockchain platform. And our design enables this without relying on any central party. And our architecture is designed to scale to real-world applications, including machine learning. And one of our main motivations is to develop the system to make it easy for developers to build privacy-preserving applications without actually needing to be a security privacy expert. So now let's briefly look at the technology components inside the Oasis blockchain platform that enables these properties. So first, when you look at the blockchain platform, there are two parts to it. One is the platform layer, and above is the application layer where the smart contract sits. At the platform layer, so first, we build technologies to enable what we call confidentiality-preserving smart contract execution to protect the computation process from leaking sensitive information. At the application layer, we enable privacy-preserving data analytics and machine learning by providing a unique framework to enable this capability. And also at the platform layer, we build new blockchain platform architecture to enable scalable smart contract execution. So now let's briefly talk about each one of the component technology in more detail. So first, let's look at the confidentiality preserving smart contract execution. So as we typically, when we execute smart contracts, users sending an input as a request to the smart contract, and then the smart contract execution transitions from the previous state to the new state. Most of today's blockchain platform, the data and the smart contracts are all in public. And however, as I mentioned, a lot of the applications, including healthcare, financial services, and so on, need to deal with the sensitive data. And hence, we need a way to provide confidentiality-preserving smart contracts. In order to do this, essentially, in the Oasis blockchain platform, when the smart contract needs to deal with sensitive data, the user's inputs, the data will be in encrypted form, and also the smart contract state will be in encrypted form as well. So as the smart contract receives the encrypted inputs, it will perform execution, and it will transition from the old state to the new state while the states are stored in encrypted form. And even though everything's encrypted in this case, still we want to be able to provide a proof of correctness for the smart contract execution. We achieve this by utilizing a number of different secure computation techniques. The goal of secure computation is to protect the computation process from leaking sensitive information. And there are two main approaches for secure computation. One is to use secure hardware. And the advantage of secure hardware is that the performance is really good. It's very close. It can be close to native computation. And it can support for general purpose computation. The other approach is using crypto-based techniques, such as secure multiparty computation. The advantage of this approach is that the crypto-based, these type of techniques oftentimes has fairly high performance overheads, oftentimes orders of magnitude overheads than native computation, and hence it can only support for limited use cases. In the Oasis blockchain platform, we combine these different approaches to enable different use cases and to satisfy different security and privacy requirements. So now let me just briefly talk about a little bit more the secure hardware side. So secure hardware essentially is a hardware-based techniques to provide a fully isolated execution environment. So for example, oftentimes called a secure enclave or trusted execution environment. So when we run the smart contract inside the secure enclave, the outside operating systems or applications will not be able to modify what's running inside and also will not be able to access what's running inside. And hence, the hardware helps provide confidentiality and integrity for the smart contract execution. And also, the hardware itself provides a hardware-based mechanism for remote attestation, where the attacker, where the remote verifier can remotely verify what has been run inside the secure enclave, and also the initial state, and how, and hence be able to verify the correctness of the execution. So in our earlier research, we are the first to conduct the research and write the paper on how we can actually combine secure hardware and smart contract execution to enable confidentiality preserving smart contracts in collaboration with researchers from other institutions. And we provide formal proofs for the security guarantees. So secure enclave is not only useful for enabling confidentiality preserving smart contract execution, it is actually a very important cornerstone security primitive, given its strong security capabilities. In particular, Secure Enclave can serve as a platform for building new security applications that couldn't be built otherwise for the same practical performance. Due to its importance, over the years, the different hardware manufacturers have all been developing different types and versions of secure hardware. However, there are still many challenges in building secure hardware. How secure can it be under what threat models? And what would you entrust with secure hardware? Your Bitcoin keys, financial data, or health data? The ultimate question is, can we really create a trustworthy secure enclave as a cornerstone security primitive that can be widely deployed to enable secure systems to be built on top? If we can really achieve this, then we can really usher the entire community into a new secure computation era. So what is the path to trustworthy secure enclave? So first, we need an open source design. The open source design provides the transparency that's needed for the whole community to come together to analyze and verify the correctness of the secure enclave design, and to enable the high assurance that's needed for the secure enclave. And also, open source design help build a community. Ideally, we would like to have formal verification of the security and correctness of the secure enclave. And also, we need to ensure secure supply chain management for the secure hardware manufacturing. Towards addressing these issues and towards these goals, we have been conducting a research project called Keystone for building an open source secure enclave. And this is in collaboration between UC Berkeley and MIT. The Keystone Enclave is, as a first step, is built on top of a RISC-V architecture to enable strong memory isolation, remote attestation, and a number of other properties and capabilities. RISC-V is an open source RISC architecture that has been developed at Berkeley and has seen really wide industry adoption. The RISC-V Foundation has more than 100 members today. By utilizing the physical capabilities of the RISC-V architecture, the Keystone design combines the hardware capabilities as well as software components to enable strong memory isolation and other types of security capabilities to enable an open source secure enclave. Recently, we have also hosted the first workshop on building open source secure enclaves. And it was great to see the leading experts and researchers from different places, including Google, Microsoft, Facebook, Intel, ARM, and other leading academic institutions all came together to discuss together and to help build a community on building open source, secure and performant secure enclaves. So that's the first component, how we combine secure hardware and cryptographic-based techniques to enable confidentiality preserving smart contract execution. So now let me briefly talk about the second component, the privacy preserving data analytics and machine learning. So first, let me give you one example case study to illustrate why we need to care about this problem. So in one of our recent study, in collaboration with researchers from Google, we explored the following question. So for example, as one trains deep neural networks, do the neural networks remember training data? And if this is the case, can attackers actually exploit this to extract secrets from the original training data by just simply querying the learned models? In our recent study, in this example, we train a language model from an email dataset called an NREL email dataset. The language model essentially provides the prediction of the next character or words when given a sequence of characters or words. And the NREL email dataset contained actual users' credit cards and security numbers to start with. So our work demonstrated that an attacker, by just simply querying this language model and by devising new attacks, the attacker can actually automatically extract the social security numbers and credit card numbers that were embedded in the original email dataset. And this is an example demonstrating that why we really need to care about privacy as we develop machine learning models. Luckily, in this case, we actually have a solution. So instead of just training a vanilla deep learning model, we show that if we train a differentially private language model in this case, then we can still achieve very high accuracy. And also, at the same time, we can significantly improve the privacy protection for the data. So differential privacy is a formal notion of privacy. At a high level, we see that a function is differentially private if one function computes over two neighboring data sets, where one data set has only one data point, for example, Joe's data point more than the other. The outcome from this computation from the two neighboring data sets are almost the same. And in this case, essentially, intuitively speaking, the differentially private function essentially ensures that an attacker from just looking at the computation outcome will not be able to differentiate whether Joe's data has been used in the computation and hence provides protection for Joe's data privacy. Differential privacy is a very powerful privacy notion, but there has not been much real-world deployment for general-purpose differential privacy. For a number of reasons, we need to have better usability for non-experts, and we need to support have broad support for analytics queries, and provide easy integration with existing data environments. No existing system addresses these issues. In collaboration with Uber, we have developed new practical solutions to enable privacy-preserving data analytics, including differential privacy, and both for data analytics and for machine learning. And some of the technologies that we have developed has been deployed at Uber. And in the Oasis blockchain platform, we are integrating these privacy-preserving data analytics and machine learning capabilities into the platform to make it easy for developers to build privacy-preserving applications without needing to be a privacy expert. So when we put together confidentiality-preserving smart contract execution and privacy-preserving data analytics and machine learning, this enables us to provide privacy protection for smart contracts. So now let me briefly talk about the scalability aspect, how we enable scalable smart contract execution. So there's a lot of conversations and discussions and proposals on scalability. So one thing I want to emphasize here is that at Oasis, we view that we have a special view for scalability. So most of the conversations on scalability is mainly focused on high transaction throughputs for simple payment transactions. However, at Oasis, we strongly believe that scalability is more than just high TPS for payment transactions, especially given the kind of applications that we want to enable, that people want to actually build for different segments in industry. It's very important for scalability, also for a complex smart contract execution. So today's there are a number of challenges for today's approaches. So first, a blockchain platform typically has three main functions, compute, storage, and consensus. So the consensus enables different parties to reach agreements, and storage stores data and the contract state, and the compute enables the smart contract execution. So most of today's blockchain platforms actually have all these three functions bundled together, and hence it's one of the main reasons it's difficult to scale. And also, even when you do sharding, it's expensive to perform certain coordinations. So in Oasis, we design and develop a new approach for scalability for smart contract execution, where we separate execution from consensus. In particular, we decouple the three key functions, the consensus, storage, and compute, into separate layers, where each layer can then scale independently and can also improve and evolve independently as well. And this way, we can achieve much greater degree of parallelization and also much greater degree of scalability. And also, we use verifiable computing to tie these different layers together to achieve strong integrity. And we utilize different types of approaches for verifiable computing. So this way, the consensus layer orders the transactions, the compute layer does the computation, and the consensus layer will do the verification of the correctness of the computation. So to summarize, for the Oasis trust model, the integrity and scalability of the Oasis platform does not depend on secure hardware. So for example, the consensus layer does not use secure hardware. And we utilize separating execution from consensus to achieve the strong integrity and great scalability. And we use verifiable computing to tie the different layers together to ensure strong integrity and security. And the Oasis platform provides a unified secure computing framework by combining secure hardware and crypto-based techniques to enable developers to have flexible choices for utilizing different types of secure computation techniques, and that's best suited for their applications. And we hope that the open source secure enclave design can help the whole community to provide a shared foundation for secure computing in the future. So I just want to give one concrete example, an application that is building on top of the Oasis blockchain platform today by dApp developers. The application is called Kara, a privacy-preserving tokenized data market for medical data. So as we all know, medical data is often locked in data silos. The goal is to incentivize doctors and patients to share data and improve medical research. So in this application, patients and users can upload their medical data to the Oasis blockchain platform, and the data will be stored in encrypted form. And a medical researcher can utilize the primitive provided by the Oasis blockchain platform, the privacy-preserving smart contracts. And in the smart contracts, the medical researcher can include code for training machine learning models and for serving machine learning models. And also the smart contract can specify terms of use. For example, how the user's data will only be used for training a privacy-preserving machine learning model inside the smart contract. It will not be used for anything else. And also, it can specify how users will be compensated. So as users agree to the terms of use of the smart contract, the user can then contribute data to the smart contract. And as the smart contract collects enough data, the smart contract can then start training machine learning models, and the medical researcher can then evaluate the effectiveness of the trained machine learning model. So using this approach, as you can see, it can significantly reduce the friction for medical researchers and pharmaceutical companies to gain access to data, to train the machine learning models, and to help them find better cures for diseases. And this is just one of many examples of the type of applications that can be built on top of the Oasis blockchain platform. Also, besides the healthcare space, it can also help providing better financial services, for example, providing decentralized credit score services, and also for example, fraud detection and so on. So we have started the journey at the Oasis Labs, and it's great to see the great support and excitement from the community. Earlier this week, we announced the launch of Oasis Startup Hub to really help build up the ecosystem for building privacy-preserving smart contracts and applications. And also today, we'd like to announce that we are also launching an Oasis University Fellowship to help foster and help support students to conduct research in a broad spectrum of different areas, including distributed systems, security, privacy, and machine learning. And you can go to our website for more information. So to summarize, at Oasis, we are building a privacy-first cloud computing platform on blockchain. One of the really exciting aspects of the blockchain domain to me is that it's a great way for us all to do different experiments. And this experimentation really helped us to push the frontiers and to empower new developments. And we hope that the work that we do here and also together with the community can lead to greater societal impact and really can help even with individuals, improve individuals' fundamental human rights. And there are many challenges in achieving this overall goal. And we are really excited to work with the whole community, and let's build the future together. Thank you.